SchoolFreeware's free Pascal program tutorials. Tutorial 14, Guess My Number Game. The code used within this tutorial can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. This is the program we'll make. This is Guess My Number. We will have the user select a game, 1 through 10, 1 through 100, or 1 through 1000. If the user puts in wrong information, such as a 6 instead of an A, B, or C, the computer will not accept the selection. So I'll put in A. We will guess between 1 and 10 in this particular game. If I were to put something other than a number, the computer will not accept that input. Put in 5, it's too low, so I'll try 8. 9. Must be 10. The computer will ask us if we want to play again, yes or no. If I say yes, we'll repeat. If we say no, the game will end. A new program has been made, and the code used to make the computer stop has been placed. Eventually, this will be deleted, but we'll use this for the time being. I'm going to need some variables for the program. We have answer for the computer's number. This is what the user has to guess. The user has to put in a guess. The guess will be an integer. Like the answer, we also need to count the number of guesses made. So I'll use cnt as an integer. We need an error to work with the val function. The user will select a game, so game will be a character. And we'll have user input, UI, will be a string, so that way we can check to see if the user has placed in a correct number. I'll start off by making the menu. So I'll repeat, I'll write line, please select a game. I'll write line as a spacer. I'll write line for game A, which will be 10. For game B, which will be game 1 through 100. Right line, game C, which will be 1000. I'll put in a right line spacer. I'll write to the screen, prompting the user to enter selection. I then place the user input into game. Now we're going to repeat until game is equal to uppercase A or lowercase a or uppercase b or lowercase b or uppercase c or lowercase c. Here I'll just hit enter and start the line where I finished off. And this whole thing is considered to be one line by the computer. So there we have our menu, repeat until, and I'll go ahead and run. So here I can repeat until I get an A, B, or C. Now, one thing that I would like to do is I have this menu constantly repeating itself, so I would like to clear out the screen. I'm going to put in a clear screen command here, which is CLR SCR. This is for a clear screen. If I were to try to run it this time, I'm going to get an error because I have to include CRT within the uses. So I'll put CRT comma, and this includes the CRT, which holds the information telling the computer how to clear the screen. CRT stands for cathode ray tube, which predates the flat screens. So CRT is for cathode ray tube, which works with the screen. So now that CRT is added into the uses, we should be able to clear the screen without any complication. And that looks a whole lot better. Once we have the menu done, we'll clear out the menu by using the clear screen. And now it's time to get the number that the user has to guess. So I want a random number. So I'll start with randomize. And then depending upon the user input, whether they entered in an A, B, or C, will determine whether we have 1 through 10, 1 through 100, or 1 through 1,000. So I'll start with a case statement. Case game of, and if the user entered in an uppercase A or a lowercase a, we'll begin. The answer will become the random 10, and this will give us a 0 through 9, so we have to add 1, so we get 1 through 10. And then I'll write line to the screen telling the user that we are in game 1 through 10. I'll end for A, and we'll go on for B, so we have uppercase B and lowercase b. Once again, we'll begin. The answer will become random 100, which will give us 0 through 99, so I'll add 1 to that so we can get 1 through 100. I'll write line telling the user that we're in game 1 through 100. I'll then end for B, and we'll go on for game C. So if uppercase C or lowercase C are entered, we'll begin. The answer is the random 1,000. And then of course we have to add 1 to that. We'll write line game 1 through 1,000. And finally, we'll end with C. Okay, the case statement is ended right here. After that, we have to get the user's guess and check to see if the guess is correct or not. So we're going to repeat until the guess is correct. So I'll repeat. Until guess equals answer. And then inside of the repeat until, we have to make sure that the user has put in a correct number. So I'll repeat. Until error equals 0. Then within that repeat until statement, we'll write line, write, enter a guess. I'll read line into user input, and then using the val function, we will try to put user input into guess and check for errors. If error is not equal to 0, then I'll just tell the user incorrect input, please try again. Now that we know that the user has inputted correct information, we can increase our counter. So we'll have CNT equals CNT plus 1. And then we'll check to see if the guess is correct or not. So if guess is less than answer, then too low. Else if the guess is greater than answer, then we'll tell the user too high. And the other possibility is that it's a correct guess, so we'll write line. You guessed my number in our counter guesses. And then finally, we'll loop until the guess is the same as the answer. Okay, let's give this a try. Go ahead, run. And find that I need to remove the semicolons from the if statement since we only have one line after each if. I can't use the semicolon, so I'll just go ahead and run now. So I'll try with game A. Enter a guess, 5, too low, 7, 9, must be 10 then. All right, and then we quit. Okay, so what I would like to do now is have the whole program repeat until the user decides to quit the program. So I'm just going to go up here to the top. I'm going to put in a repeat. I'm going to get rid of this until. And before I can go on, I need to start the counter to equal zero. This way, whatever we have for the counter down here will now be reset to zero when the new game starts. So we're going to repeat. And then here at the very bottom, until game equals capital N or game equals lowercase n. So we're going to repeat until the user does not want to play again. So now I have to prompt the user to enter in if they want to play again. So I'll start with right line. And here is where we're going to repeat. Asking the user to play again, yn. And then we'll read line, the game. And we're going to repeat until game equals uppercase Y or game equals lowercase y or game equals uppercase n or game equals lowercase n. Okay. What this repeat until does is it makes sure that the user selects either a y or an n when they want to play again and doesn't accept anything else other than that. Before I go ahead, what I'm going to do is highlight this code here up to this repeat, and then I'm going to go ahead and indent them so it looks nice and neat. And I don't need to tell the computer to stop because we're just going to repeat until the user decides to quit. So the loop will act as stopping the computer. So let's go ahead and run. All right, I'll select game A. Okay, I got it right the first time. Play again. J. 9. Yes, I'll play again. Game A. Try 5. 3. 1. Okay, there we are. Game ends. Play again. No.